What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to G-Miles World. So EA Sports is back at it again. What they did now is they created a bypass for Bo Jackson's card. So what's going to happen with that card? Many of you guys that have Raider themed teams, we've spoken about it back and forth. Bo Jackson is not like that crazy card that he used to be, like way back in the day. I'm going back to like Madden 15. Like, he's not as good as he was back then, but he's still a pretty decent back. Obviously, because on a Raiders themed team, he goes up to 99 speed. Now, with this, I didn't see this coming because I don't know why they did it like this when we have Series 4 coming Friday and, you know, people are going to be able to get Redux anyway. Why would they do this? I don't really know what's going on. I think it's about 30K training to do it. So pretty much you don't need the card. But the issue about the situation is this, right? They just pretty much destroyed the market on a lot of fronts because a lot of you guys that are watching this video right now, you already lost your coins. Like, but me, it doesn't really matter because I already was vested in him. I had many chances where I could have said, you know what, the dude's garbage. He fumbled the game away from me. He did a lot of stuff and I still kept him. So for me, I'm just a glutton for punishment. You, it might be different. So if you were looking to get Bo, you're good now. Because it's probably going to run you with that 30K training. It's probably going to run you about maybe like 280, 300K, right? As opposed to almost the 967 on stuff like that that he was selling for before. It was pretty ridiculous the prices that he was going for. The problem with this though, what EA is creating, they're making it so that a lot of players are going to have different opportunities to get the more elite cards. And that's going to create, it's going to be an imbalance, more or less. With the game itself. Why doesn't he have a 94 to 95? What is he, a 96? I don't know what he is. Bro, is he a 96 or no? Bro, what's this about? I thought that's what he was. Oh, he is a 96. All right, so look. The price of his card now, you're going to probably at this point, if you were trying to raid sell him and you was one of those guys that got him for like a million plus, you lost a lot. Like, look, it is what it is. We can't, it's nothing that we can really do about it at this point. It just dropped and plummeted. Now, again, with this situation right here, the reason that it's, like I said, a bad precedent is because they did the same thing to Barry Sanders. But a lot of you guys, I kind of had an idea about that because they mentioned it on Good Morning Madden. So I put it in a video and a lot of you guys got rid of Barry in time before they actually made the 93 overall, get a training point bypass. And then in doing that, that created a lot of different situations. So what happens now with this? We're gonna have some problems, right? Because many people got, the weekend before they did it, people were selling this card for as high as 900 to a million coins. Now it's down to 226. Obviously you require a lesser amount of training. But this is where it gets weird. I wanna explain to you guys thoroughly what happens, right, with the market. Because anybody that had the card that immediately loses the value, you're just out the cards. But now it's a buyer's market. Because look what you could do, right guys? You can actually go right now and you can lurk a lot of these lower level training cards that are out there. Whether you want to go 92s or 90 and you want to go legend, you know, you change it up, you see what it's about. You can find look at this, a 92 for 91K. You can find very, very cheap training. So 9 × 3, 27. So 270K, you'll be able to bypass that Bo Jackson. So instead of spending that 549, now you have other opportunity. But the reason that I'm saying that it's dangerous is because now all those guys that buy packs, you got to all of the values of the cards that you otherwise had, they really don't have the value. And then also, you know, we've been in Series 3 for like 35 years, it feels like, and they're going to be dropping all these reduxes now. Some of the cards that are still good are going to still be that value. You can't do anything about it. You pretty much at this point, you have to be able to figure out the value of the cards that you want and what it's going to be, and they're going to maintain their value. Like Strahan. Strahan is going to be up here. This card is extremely good, right? So when his redux drop, it's going to be the same exact thing. You're not going to get this card cheaper because there's no other card currently that has all of his numbers across the board, which is why I had to just bite the bullet and do his set again. Like, yo, I went into Weekend League. I lost like one game where I could not get any sheds. That guy, Marcus Davenport, that guy sucks. And at one point, you guys convinced me to get him. That dude is terrible. So when I actually had to go back and get this card, now all of a sudden everything changed. You know, defensively, my guys were screaming. They were going wild around the ball. Everything was good. He is a really good card. As long as they don't bother the core things, it should be fine. But this is an opportunity where all of you guys, especially my new viewers that have been coming in, yo, G-Maya, what's up? I'm trying to build my team. What do I need to do? What's going on with this? What's going on with that? Now is your time. Now is your time to figure out what's happening, because if you don't have a Raiders theme team, Is it exciting? It's probably not. Because, you know, Bo Jackson only played for the Raiders. But it opens up a little bit more opportunity. Because now, look, I got Barry Sanders yesterday, and he was like $450. So his price dropped. Everything is going to come down a little bit. And like I told you guys, with Alvin Kamara, I got rid of him because he can't spin either. He just moves really, really good. But he got caught from behind where I feel. Now, this is my personal opinion. He was out in front enough where he should have went for six. Now, he's only a 97 speed because I don't have New Orleans Saint Kem on my team. So that, you know, that's an issue. That's something that I have to be able to deal with and, you know, whatever. So I said, look, you know what? Let me get rid of this guy and go in another direction. And then I went with Barry Sanders. Now, I hate Barry Sanders equally. You know what I'm saying? It's not like I like Barry Sanders any more than, like, I don't really care. It's not that serious. The bigger issue about everything is that if they keep doing this with this training value stuff and, you know, putting all these things in there, it's going to really destroy a lot of our teams that, you know, we bought packs or we did other things to get the card. When you cost somebody to, because the thing that's weird about it, they're costing people that have the card like 200, 250K. You just lost a quarter of a million right there because they wanted to do a trade option. But in this case, there is no real reasonable reason to do that. You know, you wait until series four on Friday and you leave it like that. I don't know. Maybe it's something that I don't know about that I didn't hear them talk about. Maybe the card was really rare. Maybe he wasn't involved in the rerolls and they had to like justify people not being able to get it in packs. Maybe that's what it was. But I still don't like the fact that they can just do that at any time. They take away everything, you know, for the value of your card. And it's like, yo, look, it don't really matter. And then the other people that are trying to get in to actually get to that level. Okay, now it's good. That's why I'm giving you guys the information, but it's still unfair to some of the other people that actually went and spent the coin for him. And we're preparing for Series 4, many of us here at Jumaya's World, and we see a lot of different things that we're going to do, and we've started to get rid of players that we're going to buy back on Friday, and then they do this. So this is like a slap in the face to a lot of people that invested in Bo Jackson. But again, with everything that they do that's wild, there's always a silver lining. So what's the silver lining? Like I said, you are going to now look for cheaper training. You're gonna look 92, you could go and go like to the Legends, make sure that everything is good there, try to, because what is that, like 10,000? That's 10,000 training each. Start to play around a little bit, see like 81K. A lot of things are gonna start to plummet because people are gonna panic. It's just like the real stock market. When things get wild, like, oh, what, bro, that dude's selling for that? Like, what's that? Oh, that market share is that? You start going crazy, everybody starts to panic. So a lot of these cards, with the exception of like a Michael Strahan, like his cards are going to be still wild because no, everybody that's played against Strahan remembers his name. Dudes will send him by himself and he will be back there with you. Yo, bro, playing Patsy with your quarterback on the ground. He's that good. Now, Leroy Selman wasn't bad. I had to rate sell him because he just wasn't Strahan. But you guys get what I'm saying. So there's a lot of training out there. There's a lot of things that you can do with the value because now that EA is messing with the market, people are going to start to dump cards. People are going to get frustrated. They're going to start dumping cards. It's going to be kind of weird. Then we're going to hit Series 4. They're going to drop some cards that may be good later on, probably Team of the Year. I don't believe that Team of the Week will be pretty, you know, I don't think it's going to be OP like crazy. But it'll be something decent along those lines where people will probably see some other cards that they want to go after. Do I feel that you know, the market is going to rebound? Probably. But not by Team of the Week. The past ones that are coming up tomorrow and then the week after, probably around Team of the Year. And people are going to be able to get their hands on cards that they otherwise wouldn't be able to get on. As far as like gambling with training right now, it's kind of dull. Because some of you guys were asking about the training factor. Like, yo, G-Maya, what's up with this? You know, should I start? Like, this is all a joke. The Campus Hero players have truly declined in value. So it's not, none of them are really that good to where you would risk, you know, playing with the training like that. So I just wanted to show you guys that to make sure you understood what was going on. Even though you can accumulate a lot of training right now with the market being disgusting, I would hold on to that training until the next promo. You see what I'm saying? Because the only thing that's going to be affected, obviously, with Series 4 is that your Series 3 trophies will be cut in half. They don't bother the training that you already have, so you're not going to lose that. So I would just, you know, double up on training, have more of that available, and just wait until the next segment. Again, I don't believe that any Team of the Week player that they put out is going to have, you know, any kind of crazy value. Will Alvin Kamara get a new upgrade based on that 6-touchdown game a couple weeks ago? Yeah. Darren Waller is going to get something, but is it worth that value of going crazy? Like, oh my God, I'm going to do... No, it's not. So I would just stockpile training if you wanted to do that. No, I would not go and sell Bo for the 500 and try to save face or whatever. I'm going to leave him. Like I said, certain cards, yo, we're vested in. It's over. EA did us dirty. We keep it moving, but we still take advantage of it. And I want to make sure, although I got the back half from EA, I want to make sure that if you are looking to get a card, okay, now is your time. Now you can do it. So based off of some of us getting losses, you guys are going to get wins. So not everybody loses. Let me know what your plans are. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. One love, y'all.